In days of old, a person's date of birth was often not recorded, but it was the death date that was. January 14th was one of those days for the fellow whom we know by his pen name, Lewis Carroll. He died in 1898 at the age of 65. He was a sickly child and did not spend much time with other children in his youth, but he made up for it later. Charles Lutwidge Dodson was an English logician, mathematician, photographer, and novelist, and he is best remembered for the stories that he first told to a young lady named Alice Little. She encouraged him to write his stories, Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, in 1865, and its sequel, Alice Through the Looking Glass, in 1871. A few of Lewis Carroll's most meaningful quotes to me are:
"One day Alice came to a fork in the road and saw a Cheshire cat in a tree. 'Which road do I take?' she asked. 'Where do you want to go?' was his response. 'I don't know,' Alice answered. 'Then,' said the cat, 'it doesn't matter. If you don't know where you are going, any road will get you there. Without a plan, it doesn't matter which way you're going. Begin at the beginning, and go until you come to the end, then stop. I have proved by actual trial, that a letter, that takes an hour to write, takes only about 3 minutes to read. One of the secrets of life is that all that is really worth the doing is what we do for others. The time has come, the walrus said, to talk of many things, of shoes and ships, and sealing wax, of cabbages and kings. I can't go back to yesterday, because I was a different person then. Why, sometimes I've believed as many as 6 impossible things before breakfast. I think I could, if I only knew how to begin. For, you see, so many out-of-the-way things had happened lately that Alice had begun to think that very few things indeed were really impossible. Always speak the truth, think before you speak, and write it down afterwards. It's a poor sort of memory that only works backwards. One of the hardest things in the world is to convey a meaning accurately from one mind to another. Why is it that the people with the most narrow of minds seem to have the widest of mouths? In some ways, you know, people that don't exist are much nicer than people that do. And the one that turned out to be the most important is. Perhaps looking glass milk isn't good to drink. Encourage others.